Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. Today, we attack the fifth module of this RoboDK professional training. In this module, I will show you everything you need to know about 3D models. 3D models are the basis of any RoboDK station. You can use them to recreate the robot environment, recreate the tool, recreate the objects to manipulate, and so on. In this module, I will show you how to import the 3D models, what type of file formats are accepted, how to deal with surface accuracy, and how to make sure to retrieve all the colors. I will also show you how to deal with heavy objects that could slow down your simulation performances. I will show you how to split and regroup objects, how to use the measurement tool properly, and finally, I will show you how to scale up or down some objects in the simulation environment. Let's get started. To begin this module, let's open 05 3D models and 05A 3D model importation. Here you will find three stations, a folder, and two-step files. RoboDK supports many file formats. We will talk about that later in this video, but for now, let's concentrate on the step file. So there's two ways to open a step file in RoboDK. The first one being simply selecting file and then open, figuring out where it is using your file explorer and then opening the step file, or you can simply drag and drop the step file to your station. Here, you will find the 3D model you created. So in this case, I created this 3D model inside SolidWorks. Here it had color inside SolidWorks and there's none here. And inside SolidWorks, obviously, the logo was a perfect circle. So for this video, we will concentrate on why we have that, let's say, not round profile and why the colors disappeared. So for the colors, you can double click on the 3D model and here you have more options and then you can select change colors. If you select change colors, by the way, you can reach the same context menu by selecting tool and then change color and selecting this object. We already touched on that quickly with the light signal video, so you can go watch it back if you want. Here you will see a bunch of colors and a bunch of numbers. The colors represent the different colors that should be part of your 3D models, the model. And here you can find the number of faces or polygons of that given color. So here you have 88 polygons that are kind of whitish, 7 polygons or faces that are blue, 6 polygons or faces that are gray, and 101 polygons that are kind of gray bluish. Here, if you were to kind of add those up together, so 13 plus 88, give you 101. The reason is, for some reason, when SolidWorks save step files, sometimes it's creating kind of a surface on top of everything with kind of a neutral color. So you can just kind of get rid of it. It's kind of a duplication of the colors. So what you can do, you can select here the 101. And the first thing I would recommend you to do is just remove here the alpha channel or bring it back to zero. So this way, if you do that, it will simply make it invisible. Alpha channel is like the opacity channel and it will reveal any colors underneath it. Once you're satisfied and you know that you don't need the faces that you got rid of or that you hid here, you can right click and select delete mesh. So that will simply remove the mesh altogether. But that's a one-way road. There's no way back, no control Z possible here. If you want to get back those faces, you literally need to re-import the file from scratch. So here, now I know that I don't need those. I'm going to right click here, delete mesh. Otherwise, if I want to see them again, I can simply click on it again and bring back the alpha channel to a visible value. So here I can click right click and then delete mesh. So that's great. So now here I have my colors, but I still have the issue with the roundness of the logo, which isn't round. So this relates to a set of parameters you will find under Tools, Options, and then CAD. CAD for computer aided design. Here under 3D file importation settings, this is where RoboDK will decide how it converts the step file to something RoboDK can deal with, because RoboDK natively can't handle step file. It needs to kind of translate it to a mesh for it to work. So in this case, we will do the conversion using a linear accuracy of a certain value, angular accuracy of a certain value, and curve accuracy of a certain value. If you were to change those before importing the 3D model, you would either have better or worse curve, depending on if you increase the values, the accuracy will be worse. If you decrease the value, the accuracy will be better. So if I was to, instead of using 111, I was to use 0.5, 0.5, 0.5, click OK. And then let's create a new frame here, move that here to that frame. I will make it closer, just 300, let's say, or in fact, zero here, and 300 like that here. And if I was to re-import the same logo again, but in frame two this time, I will tool, change color, select the object here, right click, delete mesh. Let's put this one at 150 instead, so that they are very close to one another. You will see, so this is the original one. You have the little, let's say, polygons instead of the curve. And here you still have a polygon, but it's a bit better. And if I, let's say, go for it another time, and let's say this one, minus 150. Oops. And zero. Or minus 250, in fact. And tools, options, and then CAD, and let's go for 0.1 instead, 0.1, 0.1. Click OK, and then bring in the logo. And let's change the color of it. Delete mesh, I can close that here. You will see that now the curvature will be very, very circular, if I can say so. Now that looks like a circle. So if you open here the CAD importation parameters file, you will see here I had three cylinders so that I imported. So I just created a cylinder in SolidWorks and I bring it in. And I use the feature that we'll see later to kind of extract the curve. The goal was to show you more in details, like what would happen with the same exact 3D model if I was to import it with the normal setting here. So this is the default setting with 0.1 here. So as you can see with the normal setting, it looks like a circle, but it has some small lines, or it's more of a polygon. Here with 0.1, it's almost like a circle. And if you go to tools and then options and then CAD, you can click on fast import setting, which would bring here 555 instead of the default 112. And the 555 will give you that kind of result. So it's more coarse, let's say, as a result. The goal here is, with this fast import setting, is if you have very heavy 3D models, you could use that method to make them like lighter, so that RoboDK or your computer do not need to be let's say as powerful to handle it. But I will show you other methods later that also works without compromising too much on the general 3D appearance of the objects you import. That's everything for this video. I hope you liked it. In the next one, we'll explore the different file formats accepted by RoboDK and how you can save a file in RoboDK so that you can reuse it in another station later without having to go through the whole importation process. Have a great day, guys.